I'm happy for the guys. I'm happy for our school. It means a lot to the university and our alums. So from there, I'm just looking forward to next week already.
We've gone through so much. We've gone through ups and downs this year. So many, fortunate and unfortunate events throughout the year and throughout our career here. And to survive one more week in, a field of 64 with so many competitive teams is just an awesome opportunity. The first 5 minutes of the fourth quarter and the first 5 minutes of the third quarter are very, very important. And that goal kind of led over to the fourth quarter. And, I think we had the momentum from then. But Syracuse did fight back, and luckily we answered at the very end.
We talked about it. This road's been so long for our guys, and one of the things I talked about with the flights and all that being kind of chaotic this week and not knowing what our travel plans would be, we decided to take a bus, and one of the things we really wanted to emphasize to them was, hey, the bus ride up's going to be long, but the bus ride back, it's not going to matter because you're going to have so much fun and be with your best friends, and you're going to soak in just a wonderful experience, and it won't matter how long it takes. We'll go watch the second game. We already have film on both teams. We'll start preparing tonight. I want these guys to enjoy what they've done for themselves and for this program and their school. We didn't really focus a lot about what had happened in the past. We were kind of using everything that's happened in the past as motivation, but also maybe a source of inspiration. And then as a positive in that, we've been through so much heartache and disappointment before. That will help us down the road. When things get tough, we're not going to back down. We're going to want it that much more because we haven't been there. We're not going to take anything for granted. And these guys have put in the time and the effort. We've asked a lot of them, and sometimes it's been a little harder, a little more than they expected, but they've always stuck together and worked really hard.
Proud of our guys. It was a focus all week in the box offense and in the box defense. Defensively, after giving up 14 goals last week, I think our guys took it personally. I know our coaches took it personally, and so that was a tremendous focus. Having Dan back in the goal, was terrific. Mike Rogg did a great job, but Danny had been our starter all year, and the most patient we've been all year. And again, just very proud of the progress the team's made. And the hope is that we're delighted to work for another week, and we get back to work tomorrow.
Yeah, we're going in overtime. We saw the last goal. But especially from the last time we played them, they have a great face-off unit. They're very well coached, very disciplined. We won 25% of face-offs last time, and I lost by two. So I'm sure we'll be working on that all week. We're going to keep on it defensively and offensively. We can't let them score in transition. They're very good when they can run and run in transition. So it's nice to prepare for a familiar foe, but by no means is Maryland an easy team to play. So we'll be looking forward to it and get ready to play another ACC game in the semifinals.
I'd like to really just enjoy today, but if you make me think about Maryland, brothers, Mike Kennelly, Grant Kennelly knows Mike Kennelly's brother who played for us last year. Ryan Kevin Young, who plays for us, twin brothers. So, we know them on many different levels. Kevin Warren, their assistant coach, played for me at Hofstra. So, again, it's going to be one of those games that they are seniors. They're an emotional group. They're tough. They're a very physical group. They're great at the face-off X. Not just good, they're great at the face-off X. And, we were fortunate enough to beat them early in the season in overtime. And then they got us in the ACC championship. So, you get to this point, everybody's good, in the Final Four. Everybody, nobody sneaks their way in. They had to beat Syracuse, in overtime in order to advance.
Yeah,
I'm very, very proud of that we can participate in the ACC. We root for Virginia and Maryland, to be successful and to advance, and because we really respect who they are. Just that we won't root for them next Saturday.